Girl, my body don't lie.
Okay, folks, it's good to see you. Love to everybody out there. Love to all the atheists. If it's your first time, don't forget to subscribe. it's just good to see you anyway. I just want to share something today that really struck me. I've been reading Socrates, thinking about Socrates, and it inspired me to really ask more questions than I would normally ask. And I thought, well, I'm going to start asking some hard questions for atheists. And I don't want to score political points. I don't want to provide any propaganda. This has really happened. It's a real experience. There's real evidence for this. But I feel that the atheist community is showing intellectual dishonesty. And when I say that, to say that is a very serious accusation, and I don't really want to say it, but I'm faced with the evidence of the fact that there is intellectual dishonesty amongst the atheist community. The atheist, I've been listening to atheists now for a couple of years, and they bang this issue all the time. They bang it all the time. Atheism is an absence of belief. And so, you know, I am not going to believe Christianity until you provide us the evidence. And this is what they say all the time. So you get the impression that they're sincere. Not, I'm sure there are many sincere atheists, but I think this is generally aimed at the community. You get this atheist community, you get this feeling that they're really sincere, that they are this sort of practical, scientific-minded people, and they want the evidence, and they will not believe unless they get the evidence. But I've been shocked to find that this is just not true. I've been shocked to find intellectual dishonesty on that front. Because of reading Socrates, thinking about Socrates, I asked the atheist some questions the last few days, and I've been totally shocked at the replies that I've been getting. And I'm saying this is not propaganda, this is fact, there's evidence here, you can go and trace the videos. I asked, first of all, the atheist how old the earth was, and you can go and look at the evidence and the videos. And I did three videos, and not one atheist provided any evidence for how old the earth is. What they said was, go and look at this site, go and read this, or go and do that. But no one actually gave any evidence. Now, I think that is intellectually dishonest. It's no good saying to Christians, give us the evidence, when you're asked a question and you don't provide the evidence. I think that's totally dishonest. Another question I asked was, how can something come from nothing? And the old reply of the atheist, they love to do this. They love to like laugh and go, oh, don't you realize about our biogenesis? You know, that's you're asking the wrong question. You've got to go and study our biogenesis. Okay, all right. But how can something come from nothing? You've still not dealt with the question. What you've done, you've fobbed us off, all right? Tell us how something can come from nothing. And what they do is they dress it up in all kind of mystical language where they say, oh, you got to go and study it. You got to go and look at it. And they talk about it as if Greek in 300, about 1000 BC was talking of a mythical Atlantis. Go to Atlantis and see the mythical city. You'll find it. But I want to know about Atlantis. Is there evidence for it? Go to Atlantis. Go. Yeah, but I want the evidence. And it's the same with the atheists. How can something come from nothing? Go to abiogenesis. Yeah, but, well, from abiogenesis, wherever, just give us the evidence. And they don't give you the evidence. And so there's a lack of honesty there. It's intellectually dishonest to say to the Christian, give us the evidence, when you're being asked questions and you're not giving the evidence. And that's a fact. The third piece of evidence that I give for this accusation of intellectual dishonesty, and I'm not trying to score points, I'm not. This is what I've found in my experience. Because I'm reading Socrates, I thought, I'll ask a question. What about the definition of atheism? I thought, who gave this definition? And why is it the most authoritative definition of other definitions of atheism? And not one atheist has given any decent argumentation that of where the definition came from and defended that definition as opposed to other definitions of atheism by atheist scholars and the atheist community. Not one. So again, we're finding intellectual dishonesty. And they've all been very clever. They're all very clever. Many of these atheists are very, very clever. And they will they'll spin this, spin that, do say this, say that. But when you actually narrow it down, you say, yeah, those are the questions I've asked, but you've actually not dealt with them. Now, if a Christian was to do the same, these troll atheists would have a field day. And that's the other issue as well you've got to know about the intellectual dishonesty of the atheist community. I'm asking them questions and they're not giving me actual evidence. Now, one reason is purely that they know that if they actually give statements, give evidence, then they're in a vulnerable position because they can be attacked, they can be criticized. So they're holding things close to their chest, their cards to their chest, because they know if they reveal any statements and comments and evidence, it can be bashed, it can be challenged. So they're keeping the cards to the chest. And what I'm finding is they are waiting for me to make my arguments, to make my comments, and then what they do, they jump on it, they twist it, like my knockdown argument against evolution. If they knew that I follow Francis Schaeffer in my apologetics, and if they knew that Christians, when they argue these things, they have a set way of arguing, and they should know where we're coming from. So when I made an argument against evolution on the issue of chance, they completely filled in the blanks and went to task on it as if they knew what I was talking about. And not one atheist had the kindness or sense or intelligence to actually sit down and really think about what I said and realize where I was coming from. All right. But they didn't. They just jumped right into it, and they presumed that I was meaning chance in the evolutionary process. But I was on about chance at the beginning of the process. You know, that's what I was on about. And the atheists made a video, and they went to task on it, and they just jumped on it. But the thing is, I made my statement. I showed courage. I showed boldness and courage in giving an argument for what I believed in. But what I'm finding is the atheist, when I'm asking them questions, they are not showing any boldness, they are not showing any courage, they're showing a cowardly spirit. And I'm seeing that what's happening is we've got these atheist apologists out there that say atheism is an absence of belief, you show us your evidence. So the Christian provides some evidence, some argumentation, then the atheist propaganda machine jump on it, laugh at it, mock at it, attack it every way. But when the Christian apologist says, right, okay, I've got a question here, could you answer this? The card, they keep the cards to the chest. They don't give you anything, because they know if they do give you something, you can then critique them. And they don't want you to make videos making their ideas look stupid. And so there's a double standard going on. They're feeding off me, for example. They're like atheist trolls who are feeding off me, taking my arguments and criticizing me. But when I want to ask them questions, when I want to get arguments from them and evidence from them, they are playing a double standard, a dishonest game, because they're not willing to do that. They keep it to their chest because they don't want to be criticized. And that's what I've found. They're very clever. A lot of these atheists are very, very clever, and that's what I have found. And I'm not playing political games, I'm not trying to score points, but that's what I've found. I found intellectual dishonesty in the atheist community. All right, you have to play the video again and get it. I'm not going to repeat myself, but you know, you've got the points that I've said, and I'm really, really, really shocked to discover this revelation. I really am shocked to discover this revelation. I didn't think the atheist would be like that, the atheist community. You know, I'm very glad we've got people like on here who are atheist making explicit. He's brilliant. He's a brilliant, he's so clever, really good at philosophy. You know, I'm so glad there are some atheists like that on the channel. They are trying to grapple with things. I'm not saying everybody's like that, but I'm just saying, and there's a couple of others who do try, are trying, but generally speaking, it's a general statement aimed at the general community. That's the general reaction that I have had the last couple of days, all right? It's a general reaction, and I'm really shocked. I really am. I'm really shocked at the double standards, the intellectual dishonesty. I thought I just presumed that atheist community was honest, but I found that it's just not, and that's a fact. All right. Please leave your comments. Please don't forget to rate. Stop pressing like, atheist. Why do you keep pressing dislike? You stop being so mean, all right? Stop being so mean. I'm the nicest Christian apologist you'll ever meet, okay? All the best to you. God bless.